We are heading into the worst recession in all of our lifetimes. Cue the fire. I know there's already fire back there, but cue more fire. Also, put this one in your sippy cup and suck it. Remember 2008? We had one of the worst financial, greatest financial collapse, crisis of ever. Okay, now let's just rewind the clock a little bit. We were layered in debt like no other, up to our eyeballs. So we suffered a horrific recession. And at that time, the debt per taxpayer, you, was $91,000. You're like, I'm not paying $91,000. I know. We had a the national debt was $9 trillion. And it was bad. People were like, oh my gosh, we're not going to survive. It was a rough time. Well, you just wait, because this next one is going to be more rougher. 30 over $30 trillion. Congratulations. You did it, politicians. I don't blame anyone in specifically. You guys. All you guys out there. Debt per citizen. Now it's per taxpayer. You guys paying taxes? It's just not whatever that number was. It's now $241,000 that you are going to have to pay when this thing pops. And actually, I see it on my other screen. It was $91,000. So now it's $241,000. Oh, and by the way, I think we're going to go into even more debt. I know, shocker, right? And I'm actually betting on it, which I will explain to you in a minute. Some of you guys are like, I'm so confused on the swing trade TLT. It's not a swing trade. But Bravo, I thought you swung trade everything. Or do you swing trade everything? No. How do you have gold? Here, pretend this. How am I going to, you know, it's a commodity. What? How am I swinging that? I mean, I guess you could swing trade debt. Very boring swing trade. But here is another. I'm going to give you so many reasons for a recession. Number one, euro dollar futures. That inverted. And every single time. And people are like, what's that? Well, it's probably one of the largest markets in the history of mankind. And we had an inversion on it. And that was in December. And then January. And February. And March. And they're betting futures that this thing is going to break, and that the Fed is going to go from right now, they're tightening. Oh, we're tightening conditions. We're going to tighten this thing to, oh my gosh. And then for some of you that are even lost even more, you're like, what's euro dollar? Okay. Everything that's outside of our little country. Okay. That's the euro dollar. And it is huge. And there's no real way to even calculate what it is. Some people say it's four times. And our government's like, wait, never thought about when the dollar leaves here. Huh, that's tricky. So it's roughly the second largest market in the world, and no one even knows how to calculate it. And the derivatives behind that, it's huge. So we have the global yield curve, the euro dollar, inverting, recession, guaranteed every single time. Silver has nothing to do with it. It's oil. Stack it though if you want to. Good luck stacking oil. So oil, when you go above, right, 50%, which we did that. Oh, recession. Number three, this dynamic yield curve. See on the side with the red? And then over here above my head, you have the blue. This is the stock market over here. This, when the one over there on red inverts, this one crashes. And let me show you what it should look like. Okay, over here, see this? See this right here? See that? The red and red? Okay. Now what's going to happen is the Fed is going to take this side right there, and they're going to go, oh, you know what we're going to do? We're going to move that up there, all right? When they move that up there, it's all broken. Actually, if you're looking at it, this is above there. So that's already broken. Broken number one, broken number two. Now we're going to come in with broken number three. You see, let me show you. This is, what was this, 2013, something like that. Okay, see on the one side, the yield curve? Oh, perfect. Nice amount of risk from short to long. Now, if you want to know if a market's going to crash or not, you slide this thing all the way over, and you can even animate it and go, oh, okay, I see we have a problem here. You want to know when the problem is? See this red? This red needs to go above this side. Now, wait for it. It's going to happen. And then this, you're going to see this is the stock market, okay? The stock market is going to crash. Now, it takes time, but right about there, did you see it? Did it invert almost? Yeah, there it is. It's inverted. The market's going to go. Ta-da. And then there it goes. It crash, crash, crash all the way down. And we can move this. Let me move it over here. See, once it crashes, it equalizes. We're like, good. Oh, it inverted again. And fwabam, crash. And now we are moving it all the way over, which I cannot do because my fingers are currently broken. But just trust me. Over over here above my head. It's broken again. But now, with all of this debt and all this brokenness, there's actually a way to make money from all this. Now, it's just paper trading. I know it might look for real, kids. I mean, 190 shares, that's almost $25,000. It's probably more than $25,000. That would be the trade. And this is a trade that I am making. Well, like, we go back to 2008. Here's 2008. I believe we're like in this area, you know, right prior to that green recession. Ooh, looks like I'm down $14. I mean, that's not bad for $25,000. All right. So looking at this one, I believe, and I could be totally wrong, that we're going to go into a recession. If we do not go into a recession, then I'm totally wrong. But if we do go into a recession, see, I think the Fed's going to change course. And how do I know that? Because they do it every single time. So on this one, from before the recession, we'll start right there, all the way to the tippy top. This is not like crypto money, kids. It's 32%. It's also a long period trade. This is no capital gains tax. So when I'm accumulating beforehand, I have to wait 12 months on that one. Now, my swing trades, no. Now, also, you could see that line, that support and resistance that I draw? This is a very strong support and resistance. And I've told you for about a month, maybe a month, I said, this is my accumulation zone, okay? And hopefully, maybe I'm wrong, we'll get a little green area like that. That is a recession. And what happened from my accumulation zone all the way up to the very tippy top, it was about 31%. But please, whatever you do, do not confuse these trades with gold, with silver, with Bitcoin. Like, can you swing trade Bitcoin? No. That's why I had to create a course on how to trade crypto. It trades completely different than swing trading or intradays like SQQQ. What were we up today? 3%? And dang, I got pretty darn close, right? 3% on the dot. Well, 3.04 if you're really into dots. And also talking about commodities, you know, oil, when I've been jumping up and down for the last how many days, I said, take profit. If you don't take profit, I'm going to come over to your house. I'm going to kick in your door. I'm going to put in your password, which is your anniversary. You should have changed it. And I'm going to click the button, take profit. Here is oil. Have I not been saying, look, see this zone? Oh, hey, look, you're already out of this. See where it says sell? No, I was telling you. I mean, from the top to where we are now. What are you guys down? 17%. Come on, Larry. Like, you finally need an indicator to come on to tell you? And if you want to be your own boss, handle your own finances, do this. Do swing trading right here. I know it says 1,000, but click the link. It'll be really discounted. Then when you're really good and you need trades, go to my watch. This is what I trade every day. And then when you hit Bala status, do the Crypto Stocks University. But bring your diapers because it's going to get crazy really soon. We're coming into the apex. Watch Bitcoin. Woo! Cue the nukes. And also, for those of you that are into things called like earnings and PE ratios and fundamentals, well, there's going to be a whole lot of reversions. I'm sorry, that would be revisions. I am new to the English. And Lance Roberts puts out some good stuff, real investment advice. See those dotted lines way up above my head where they're like, it's going to go this way. This is the way it's supposed to go. Well, I can tell you it's probably not going to go the way in the everything bubble. I know, not when it pops, right? You're fine. Well, until the bridge gives way and you're like, whoa, sharks. The only two previous periods with similar deviations, guess what those are? That would be the financial crisis and the dot-com bubble. Let me move my bubble head out of the way so you can see that lovely chart of deviation of earnings. See, what you think it is isn't what it's going to be. And let me show you by using diagram, like the tech bubble. So they're going to measure this. They're like, okay, so let's just draw this line. We're probably going to hit up there. And then all of a sudden, lo and behold, out of nowhere, you lose all your money. Or the real estate bubble, like this, right? You draw, this is their trend lines. They're like, I clearly see it going up there. Well, you forgot to mention that. Okay, you didn't see that? And just to let you know, on this channel and throughout my entire life, I've always put my money where my mouth is. And I'm very upfront. This is what I'm doing. 2007, 2008, sold, more so 8, got out of everything. I own real estate in Texas. I own real estate in California. I own businesses, you name it. I was out of everything. I said, I have a strong inkling that this is going to pop. But I did say, I will be back for another day. And I did. And this is, here, let me draw this line for you. I don't think we're going to continue that way. I think we may go a little bit more and then down into the hair. Or as some of you guys call it in the comments section, my gigantic pineapple of blonde hair. Also, in regards to more things that are just going to pop this bubble that we got, you know, your gas prices, you see those at the pump. Okay, it's just not gasoline. It's used for a few more things, like everything. So when you see high oil prices, just know it's only going to affect this small group of letters. And which one did you see first? I will tell you, I don't know why. Cassettes, right? So if there's a big, you know, you were thinking about getting out there and buying your cassette tape now, you better do it now. And you know what? I just say thank goodness that, see this, life jackets. Oh, already got it. I won't have to pay high oil costs for my life preserver. Also, the reason why I have this is so that I'm asking you to click the like button. When you do that, it saves the channel. And my job on this channel is to save you from these guys that are gonna tell you it's gonna be really bad, which it will be. But they have a solution for it, right? The solution is burn it all down and then they'll build back better. Sorry, they actually give you a 10% chance that it's all catastrophic. Everything just, it is gone. You're gone, everything's gone. 1 out of 10 chance. A slightly higher chance that we actually recover. So the people that are running the show, that are running the world, give this a 90% chance of collapse. And then I sit over here trying to uncover all of this for you. And by the way, they have a 3% optimistic. That's not very good. But at least we can make money. At least I think we can. Well, until they roll out their digital, you know, currency, then we can. But maybe at that time, we'll have a little island together, right? We'll all just trade seashells. All right, you clean the house, I'll give you 3 seashells. Because my wife, she's not lifting a finger. Also, hopefully I'm a little bit better than these guys that you see on TV. What are we doing today, Jimmy? Just checking him. Hey! Thinking, buddy. And also, real quick, let's check that TLT position, because I know you guys are like, oh, loser. Okay, how are we doing over there? Hey, looky there, I'm up 862. All right, I guess I'll be taking my wife out to McDonald's. And I will see you in the next video.